Prime Minister Abdelmalek Sallal is to chair a government meeting next week to address vice pending files. Algeria's bank governor urges banking institutions to comply with the rules in relation to foreign exchange transactions. And internationally, the United Kingdom reopens its embassy in Tehran after 4 years of closure. Those were today's top stories. Thank you for joining us live on the news. Prime Minister Abdelmalek Sallal is expected to chair shortly a high-profile meeting bringing together government officials and governors of all national provinces to address some outstanding issues and files related to the current financial juncture of the country as part of efforts to overcome the current oil crisis and cushion its adverse effects on the national economy. Let's follow this report.
Ensuring a smooth social comeback as well as a calm academic year free of open-ended strikes, establishing a roadmap for the newly created delegate provinces and setting up a rescue program for the provinces that were ravaged by the recent unprecedented floods. These are some of the files that are to be discussed by Prime Minister Abdelmalek Sallal, who is set to chair a governmental meeting bringing together government officials and governors next week. This high-profile encounter is one of its kind for Sallal's government. Notably, it comes after the recent reshuffle undertaken by the president concerning the newly appointed governors of provinces as well as establishing 10 new delegate provinces. The latter suggests that the expected meeting is of high importance amid the free falling of oil prices on the international markets, as well as the devaluation of our national currency, which seriously threatened the national economy that is heavily dependent on hydrocarbons. All these facts show that various challenges lay ahead and waiting to be overcome. Therefore, the government must swiftly act and find ways and avenues to generate money and accomplish the ongoing development projects in various provinces. Ministers and governors are set to meet next week with an aim of finding solutions to reduce the burden on the national treasury under the theme of rationalizing public spending to overcome the current oil crisis. The recent unprecedented floods that hit the eastern provinces of the country dealt a heavy blow to the government, which is forced to implement a rescue plan for those who were damaged by the floods. Fighting and eradicating bureaucracy, as well as distributing idle housing units fairly, will also be on the government's agenda.
National Education Minister is set to meet this weekend with sector unions and parents' association to prepare for the next academic year and address the outstanding files at a time when the social partner still adheres to its threats to paralyze the school year. Osama Snusi has the details.
A new meeting for the Minister of National Education, Nouria Ben Ghabrit, with the sector unions, along with the Committee of Students' Parents, will be held on the new school year's eve, which is troubled with a political conflict that was introduced as an amendment that included replacing academic Arabic with Algerian dialect. Despite Prime Minister Sallal's interference to end the conflict and put an end to the strife that dominated the sector for a long time, Ben Ghabrit's task to end students' anger will not be easy, notably after it was decided that first and second year secondary school failed students will be excluded.
The problem that parents will face at the beginning of the school year is the issue of their children's expulsion. Around 50% of students who come from middle school are either excluded or have failed a year, so they are not allowed to repeat for the second and the third time. This problem will hinder the smooth running of the new school year.
A controversial school year is expected in the shade of education inspectors and school bursars' threats to slow it down, and the latter will result in a menace to Minister Ben Ghabrit, along with students who are considered as the minister's first enemy amid an economic crisis in a government that got used to temporary solutions.
In economy-related news now, the governor of the Bank of Algeria, Mohamed Lkassasi, has urged banks and financial institutions in the country to strictly comply with their obligations in relation to foreign trade and foreign exchange transactions. More details on the matter with Mohamed Barazwan in the following report.
As oil prices plunge, banks are urged to strictly abide by the legislation. Mr. Lkassasi said this will help maintain the financial stability of Algeria as the economy faces scathing repercussions from the recent drop in oil prices, which affects the balance of payments and public finances. According to Mr. Lkassasi, all exporting countries are expected to see the balance of current accounts deteriorate while their fiscal space contracts. Given the likely acuity of an external shock in 2015, banks are expected to strictly comply with their obligations as authorized intermediaries, especially with foreign trade and exchange operations in the context of the current dinar convertibility despite its latest depreciation versus the euro and the US dollar. He explained that the Bank of Algeria will strengthen controls and ensure the bank's compliance with the new ratio commitments related to shareholders' funds, which went down from 4 to 2% in December. He added that in 2015, the rate of audits for transactions with foreign companies will also be accelerated. Risky activities such as import operations, those made from certain countries whose tax systems, customs, and anti-money laundering are notoriously known for their laxity and tolerance, will especially be monitored, he underlined.
In tonight's in-depth story, we'll shed light on Algeria's tourism activity, where despite all the natural resources Algeria has, the government is still powerless to promote tourism in a country that has the opportunity to become an unchallenged touristic destination. And the Ministry of Tourism bets on an upgrade for the sector within the 5 years, especially desert tourism. More details with Osama Snoussi.
Algeria is considered as one of the most beautiful countries in the world regarding its exotic nature, which is characterized in its coastline and vast desert. However, these natural resources suffer a big negligence, and tourism witnesses a big stagnation due to lack of hotels and touristic infrastructure. We came for vacation, but unfortunately we found nothing. We called the government to pay more attention to tourism by building hotels. Things are not going right at all. As you can see, there is nothing. We don't care about tourism and its quality. We always make unfruitful decisions. Tourism should be taken care of today. In 2030, we will see the same level of the 1970s. Despite the accusations addressed to the custodians of this important sector, the response from the representative of Tourism Ministry was positive, as he confirmed that tourism in Algeria will see a qualitative leap within the next 5 years, notably desert tourism that will benefit from more than 900 projects.
Algeria's tourism strategy depends on the Sahara Desert, which promotes tourism from abroad. We have more than 900 projects underway in the Algerian Sahara Desert. And in 5 years from now, Algeria will have a potent touristic position on the international market. 450 various projects are under achievement in the region.
Encouraging touristic investments through funding private investors to build hotels and entertainment complexes will revive the suffering sector, which can be an important income source for the government.
Still with tourism, over 1 billion people travel to another country each year. This is according to the latest annual data issued by the World Tourism Organization. This kind of list is usually pretty much the same, but every now and then a new entry or a drop in popularity makes for a surprise. Let's follow this report. According to the latest annual data released by the World Tourism Organization, over 1 billion people travel to another country each year. This kind of list is usually pretty much the same, but every now and then a new entry or drop in popularity makes for a surprise. attracting a whopping 83 million visitors each year. It seems that tourists around the world find it difficult to resist the charms of France, nicknamed the City of Light. Paris is exceptionally popular with tourists from the Americas and Asia, thanks to places like the Eiffel Tower, Louvre Museum, and Notre Dame Cathedral. Sitting into a distant second place position on the list of most visited countries is the United States. Interestingly, while it attracts 16 million fewer visitors per year than France, long-haul tourists from Europe and Asia come to see America's vast landscapes and famous cities, the Grand Canyon, New York, San Francisco, and Yellowstone National are the favorites. Like France, most of Spain's visitors come from other EU countries, though it's just a fraction of the size of China. It attracts around the same number of tourists each year. The country's immaculate southern coastline is popular with sun seekers from cooler climates and north from May to October. For culture vultures, the Spanish cities of Barcelona, Madrid, and Sevilla offer plenty to see and do throughout the year. All these whopping numbers and figures might drive you to think, where is Algeria in all this? Well, unfortunately, the tourism in Algeria is very humble in comparison. Despite the fact that after the turmoil that many Arab countries are living, Algeria was not chosen as a tourist holiday destination. Algeria was ranked number 5 most visited place in Africa, with 2 million visitors each year, a very humble number to what Algeria has and what it can offer to its beloved visitors. The capital, Algiers, is one of the Maghreb's most urban and charismatic cities, with a heady, nostalgic mix of colonial and modern architecture. Across the north are stunning coastlines, lush rural hinterland, and a number of well-preserved Roman cities. Algeria's trump card is, though, its extraordinary Saharan region. Whether it's a glimpse of the sand seas that surround Timimoun or a plunge headlong into the far south of Tamaras, these are the desert landscapes of dreams and legend. Perhaps best of all, Algerians welcome visitors with warmth and a genuine curiosity. For accessible adventure and a complex, enthralling cultural odyssey, head for Algeria now.
In the UK-Iran cooperation track, the British Embassy in Iran has reopened nearly 4 years after it was closed. British Foreign Secretary Philip Hammond attended a ceremony in Tehran with Iranian diplomats to mark the reopening, while Iran has also reopened its embassy in London. The United Kingdom embassy was closed back in 2011 after it was stormed by protesters during a demonstration against sanctions. Mr. Hammond is the first UK Foreign Secretary to visit Iran since 2003. The reopening comes weeks after Iran reached a deal with 6 world powers aimed at curbing its nuclear program. In other world news, 10 people have been killed as Typhoon Goni dumped torrential rain in northern Philippines, triggering heavy landslides and floods. Several people were killed when houses were submerged under rocks and mud. Others are reported missing in flooded areas. Thousands of people have been evacuated to higher ground and some domestic flights were cancelled. At one point, Typhoon Goni was packing winds of up to 195 km per hour. However, it weakened as it moved northward off Taiwan's east coast. Elsewhere in India, K. Cochin International Airport Limited in Kota Kinabalu has become the first airport in the world to be powered entirely by solar power. A 12 megawatt solar PV plant spread over 50 acres was inaugurated 2 days back near the airport's cargo complex. The power plant took 6 months to entirely achieve and has come up at a cost of $9.5 million. Technically speaking, the airport is now grid neutral, as it will give back more than it will consume from the grid. The newly installed solar power plant can generate between 50,000 to 60,000 kilowatt in an hour per day. In track and field news now, after a surprising stumble in the semi-final, World Athletics champion Usain Bolt sprinted to his third 100-meter world title on Sunday, cementing his statue as the fastest man in the world and holding off a deep field of challengers that included four Americans. The 29-year-old Jamaican sprinter locked up the gold medal in 9.79 seconds on the track where he first became Olympic champion 7 years ago. And now we move on to football news. Portugal's Sporting Lisbon have retained the services of talented Algerian international Slimane Slimani as he signed a new contract extending until 2020. More details in the following report.
After highly rated teammate João Mário committed his future to the club early in the day, Islam Slimani followed suit, penning a new deal with a 30 million euro minimum release clause included at the Estadio José Alvalade. The 27-year-old Algeria international forward, a reported target for England's Premier League duo West Ham and Tottenham towards the latter stages of 2014-2015, was a key contributor as Sporting Lisbon upstage rivals Benfica in last week's Supercopa Cândido de Oliveira, the country's Super Cup. Islam Slimani said he is very happy with this renewal with Sporting Lisbon. It is recognition for the work I have been doing to the club, Slimani said via Sporting's official website. He added that he's evolved as a player and hopes to continue to win more titles at Sporting Lisbon after the Cup and the Super Cup. Islam Slimani has scored 25 goals in 64 matches in all competitions since joining Portugal's Sporting Lisbon from Algerian First League side CR Belouizdad way back in 2013.
And with this, ladies and gentlemen, we come to the end of our News in English brought to you live from Zay News. Thank you for joining us. Bye-bye.